The coral reefs in the Red Sea are among the most fascinating underwater worlds on our planet. These reefs, which are only found in the shallow zones of warm tropical oceans where the sunlight filters through the water, are enormously complex and extensive ecosystems in their own right. They are sometimes known as rainforests of the ocean, because the wealth of species found here can only really be compared with that in tropical rainforests. We prepare for a dive that will present us with a veritable fairy tale world featuring a breathtaking diversity of life forms. Almost as soon as we are in the water, we are greeted by a shoal of sea goldies. These striking orange-yellow fish can form shoals of up to 2,000 individuals. They eat plankton and like to gather at the edge of the reef where the current will drive their preferred prey towards them. A pair of blue tangs appear right in front of us and quickly flee. The coral hind gives us considerably more time to admire it. Coral hinds are among the largest fish on the reef, and as predators, they are high up in the food chain. The Red Sea bannerfish is a far gentler creature. It is one of the family of butterfly fish, which includes some of the most beautiful fish species in the coral oceans. In contrast, the common lionfish is far from being harmless. Its long spines contain a powerful poison. The vivid yellow blue-cheeked butterfly fish is a close relative of the Red Sea bannerfish we have just encountered. The sea anemone is a class of creature known as anthozoans, or flower animals. Although the orbicular batfish looks similar to the butterfly fish, it is not, in fact, a relative. Its preferred habitat is deep water, and in the Red Sea, these fish can be extremely trusting. The partnership between the sea anemone and the anemone fish is one of the best examples of a symbiotic relationship between completely different creatures or species of plants, in which both parties benefit from the symbiosis. Striated fusiliers always remain in large shoals in the free water above the reef, where they can hunt for animal plankton. Giant mound corals are a kind of stony coral, which form calcium exoskeletons. They can become extremely large and sometimes form dome-like blocks on the reef. The long tentacles of the anemone are equipped with stinging cells, used to immobilize small fish, which can then be digested. Only the anemone fish can move between the tentacles without being harmed. Thus, the anemone fish is protected from larger predators here, while at the same time it performs a valuable service to the anemone by defending it against predators. This impressive fellow belongs to the family of wrasses and is known as a humphead wrasse. It is one of the largest fish on the reef and can grow to an amazing size. The biggest specimen ever caught was 7.5 feet in length and weighed 470 pounds. A green sea turtle appears on the reef. This species was hunted to the very brink of extinction because its meat was highly prized as the main ingredient of green turtle soup. We once again meet the Red Sea bannerfish, as usual, patrolling their territory in pairs. While swimming, the turtle only uses its front fins for propulsion. The rear ones are used purely for steering. Two surgeon fish take the opportunity to pick away at parasites. A small group of cardinal fish are lying in wait under a protective outcrop, while the large humphead wrasse goes on its rounds. It has powerful jaws, which can easily bite through the shell of crustaceans. However, it represents no danger to these little shoaling fish. Another turtle appears near the surface. It is not alone. Two suckerfish are stubbornly attempting to attach themselves to its shell. These fish have dorsal fins, which are modified to form suction pads, and this allows them to fasten on to larger creatures or boats and hitch a lift in this way. A barnacle has already had some success here. This crustacean, which looks like a small volcanic cone, has established a permanent home for itself on the turtle's shell. The turtle itself doesn't seem to mind, being predominantly interested in the seagrass bed on the bottom of the ocean. Like all sea turtles, the green turtle lays its eggs on the beach and leaves them to hatch in the sun. The female always chooses the same beach where she herself hatched out many years earlier. And exactly how she manages to find this spot again remains a mystery to scientists. A large shoal of mackerel comes past, looking like a spherical cloud. These fish always live in shoals, with each individual reacting to the movements of all the others. This huge group which results occasionally appears to move like a conscious organism. This giant moray has a completely different lifestyle. Like all members of its family, it hunts alone and as a rule is active at night. The monochrome red saber squirrelfish is also a night hunter. During the day, it remains hidden in caves or crevices in the coral reef. Shipwrecks can become an important part of the ecosystem in coral oceans because they offer retreats and hiding places to a wide variety of fish species and other marine creatures. Moreover, they quickly become covered in coral and can consequently form the nucleus of completely new reefs. Here a colorful and very mixed group has gathered among the rusting steel parts of the vessel. The wreck looks as though it has been planted with a wide variety of coral. The Red Sea bannerfish also feels at home on this artificial reef. It always remains close to reefs and never swims out into the open water. The bizarre cornetfish is quite unmistakable with its needle-like body and disproportionately elongated mouth. Sea urchins hide among the coral. They belong to the class of creatures known as invertebrates, and they protect themselves with a hard external skeleton covered in poisonous spines. This magnificent creature is a Spanish dancer, a kind of sea slug. The red-pink segments are its gills. The masked puffer can easily be recognized by its facial coloring, which looks like a mask. Like all pufferfish, it is highly poisonous. A large shoal of striated fusiliers is swarming above us. They are not regular inhabitants of reefs, preferring to remain in open water. Sea fans are among the most spectacular manifestations of coral life. They form large, fan-like structures with delicate branches that can reach a diameter of up to 6.5 feet. These corals live from tiny plankton which they filter out of the current. Consequently, fans are always arranged across the direction the current takes. These large, tree-like structures provide protection for a number of small life forms such as crabs, shrimp, and starfish. Here, a Bali fire anemone has taken up residence between the branches of the sea fan. Although this species of anemone seems similar to the coral itself at first glance, the two are very distant relatives. Unlike the stony coral that forms the reef, this tree coral does not have a hard exoskeleton. Instead, it retains its shape by means of increased water pressure acting on their inner surfaces. A shoal of black-spotted rubberlips floats above the reef. These fish are predominantly nocturnal, and during the day they stay close to the reef in shoals. Stony corals are the real master builders of the reef. They are colonies of tiny creatures which construct calcium exoskeletons. When the coral polyp dies, the skeleton remains, and over the years, generations of coral polyps construct their own exoskeletons on top of earlier colonies. This is how huge reefs are created, forming the foundation of life for the entire ecosystem. We have encountered this masked puffer before. Like all pufferfish, it leads a solitary existence. By contrast, the yellowfin goldfish are genuine shoaling fish. During the day, they remain on the edge of the reef in huge, magnificent shoals. They do not really become active until nightfall, when they fan out to hunt tiny invertebrates that live on the seabed. In the process, they sometimes dig up the sandy floor so thoroughly that large clouds of sand are created. Blue-cheeked butterfly fish, with their flat bodies, have adopted in outstanding fashion to life on the reef, and they always remain close to the coral branches. They feed on the coral polyps, and each one has a small hunting ground which it defends against other members of its own species. Even more striking than the butterfly fish is the angelfish, which are among the most richly colored sea creatures of all. A zebra lionfish wends its solitary way through a shoal of sea goldies, which make sure they keep a respectful distance from its poisonous spines. These moon-tailed bullseyes are far more sociable creatures. Their huge eyes have adapted to their nocturnal life. The lionfish is also predominantly active at night. During the day, it hides in crevices or caves and is seldom glimpsed in open water. It waits patiently for its prey to make an appearance, then it sucks the hapless creature into its huge mouth by suddenly lowering the pressure inside. However, the bullseyes have nothing to fear. They are too big for the lionfish to consider one a possible victim. The skittish shoal of green chromies scurries around among the stony coral, watched with interest by a black-tip grouper. The chocolate-dip chromies, with its striking black and white coloring, belongs to the extremely extensive family of pomacentrids. As is the case with bullseyes, they also live in loose shoals.
Mollus corals, seen here with pufferfish above them, are a species of stony coral. The undulating shape is reminiscent of some kinds of the blue-spotted ribbon-tail ray often buries itself in the sand as a form of camouflage. This is also where it finds food in the form of worms, shrimp, and shellfish, which it digs up from the sand. Unlike the larger manta ray, the ribbon-tail always remains on the seabed and is never seen in open water. The stings at the base of its tail contain a powerful poison that could be deadly even for human beings. This ray is not aggressive, but if you were to step on it by mistake, the consequences could be pretty serious. The black surgeonfish is dark brown in color with only a white ring around its tail to form a contrast. Surgeonfish take their name from two spines, one on each side of the tail, which are as sharp as scalpels and can be extended when the fish is provoked. Yellow-edged leer tails are a subspecies of sea bass. Lunar fusiliers are typical shoaling fish. If they are attacked, they attempt to confuse the predator with synchronized swimming movements. As it swims past, the leer tail once again displays to us its splendid coloring. As plankton eaters, fusiliers are quite capable of friendly cohabitation with different fish species and often mix with shoals of other types. Here they have combined with some striking yellow gold saddle goatfish and silver big-eyed trevallies to form a multicolored The magnificent Red Sea bannerfish also enjoys a diet of plankton, but they tend to remain in more sheltered areas and do not form shoals. Table corals produce a hard exoskeleton and are therefore considered a species of stony coral. They create tree-like shapes with numerous branches. In the deeper water at the side of the reef, they grow into structures resembling tables, since this permits them to absorb as much light as possible. Stony corals live in a symbiotic relationship with single-cell algae, which require sunlight for their photosynthesis. Consequently, like plants, these corals require locations which are rich in natural light.
A shoal of sea goldies dodges around the multi-layered coral forest. Corals can appear in a wide variety of forms. Thus, solid stony corals form the foundation of the reef, which is then settled by lace-like species such as sea fans and table corals. Tree corals also have no hard skeleton and move gently in the current. A moray eel is lurking among the corals, on the lookout for a victim, its long body hidden in the hollow space. During the night, the reef takes on a completely different appearance. When an ultraviolet spotlight is trained upon it, this mushroom coral glows with a pale fluorescent light. A hammerhead shark approaches from the distance. Its distinctive shape makes this species of shark, which can be up to 13 feet in length, one of the most striking inhabitants of the coral ocean. However, it is only an occasional visitor to the reef, since its sphere of activity extends This curious creature is a Pleurobranchus grandis, a species of side gill slug. Numerous species of sea slugs can be found in the Red Sea, some of them with extremely beautiful coloring. A black and white snapper continues on its solitary path in the middle of a shoal of chocolate-dip chromies. This fish, which can grow to a considerable size, prefers open water, which it finds in deeper lagoons or on the steep edges of reefs. Once again, we encounter a green sea turtle, resting on the seabed before setting off again in search of food. With its distinctive needle-shaped body, this stunning creature is known as an elegant unicorn fish. Like the majority of unicorn fish, it is extremely striking with its brightly colored appearance. Unlike unicorn fish, which tend to be solitary hunters, yellowfin goldfish like to spend the daylight hours in large shoals. Not until night comes do they split up, setting off individually in search. The Spanish dancer we saw earlier in a relaxed position has now become active, revealing itself in all its splendor.
This large sea slug swims through open water with an undulating motion, and it now becomes apparent where its name originates. The resemblance to a flamenco dancer in traditional dress is quite striking. Currently, we have disturbed this masked puffer somewhat. When it senses danger, it fills itself with water, making it look larger than it actually is. Now that dusk is approaching, these bullseyes are becoming active. Their shoals frequently contain other shoaling fish, such as these black striped sweepers, which flash silver in the spotlight. They hunt for animal plankton at night, always remaining in the safety of the shoal. Occasionally, very mixed shoals congregate at places which offer protection, such as under this roof. Many species of fish avoid open water whenever possible and tend to remain in sheltered spots like this. This surgeonfish seems to have rather a nervous disposition, hurrying away when we dive slowly between the protruding coral. Toothed cardinal fish, which has distinctive colored stripes on its body. Tail butterfly fish make an appearance. They live in couples and generally patrol their small territories, which they will defend against other members of their own species with their partners. A shoal of striated fusiliers swirls around over the reef in search of food. These fish feed on animal plankton and are frequently found in the open water areas near the reef. Cornet fish seems rather exotic with its highly individual shape. A large shoal of sea goldies dodges around the reef like an orange cloud. Naturally, all this activity attracts predators, such as this barracuda and a snapper. These creatures are extremely sociable and always live in small groups known as schools. The gray spots on the belly of the dolphins indicate that these particular creatures are Indo-Pacific bottlenose dolphins. However, the patchwork of gray spots only appears on older animals. With a length of up to 8.5 feet, they are one of the smaller species of dolphin. They can frequently be found in tropical and subtropical oceans, and they tend to remain close to the coast in schools of between 5 and 15 animals. Dolphins are curious, playful animals. Although this can hardly be the first time they have seen divers, they are determined to take a closer look at us. This results in a fascinating encounter with these absolutely extraordinary creatures. A shoal of yellowfin goldfish has pressed itself close to the reef for safety. Only gradually do they venture out again.
The butterflyfish also prefers to wait in the safety of a cave until the coast is clear once. These red sea anemone fish prefer in any case not to stray far away from the anemones which provide them with protection. The stinging tentacles of the anemone are deadly to other fish, but the anemone fish enjoys immunity due to a special layer of mucus on their skin, and thus they are able to remain inside the anemone.
Consequently, they are forced to seek safety in numbers by forming shoals. A shoal of chocolate-dipped chromies plays over a large field of porites coral. This type of coral has characteristic finger-like pillars and forms large patches. This makes little impression on the turtle, however. It has found something else to eat. The coral hind is also too big to pay much attention to such things. This blue-spotted ribbon-tailed ray keeps a low profile, as always, waiting half buried in the sand for its prey. A five-saddle parrotfish has withdrawn to a small cave for a sleep. Like all parrotfish, it has powerful jaws and can therefore graze on the algae layers on the stony coral. The giant moray would not be content with such meager fare. It lurks in wait for small fish that it can feast upon. A sea anemone on its travels. These creatures are semi-sedentary. They normally remain in a fixed location, but they are capable of moving to a new home. Nook. Only its protruding poisonous spines are visible. It is quite rare for a moray eel to leave its cave. Only now can we see just how long its snake-like body is. These creatures can reach a length of more than 7 feet. Stands out from the swarm of black and white chocolate dip chromes. sea cucumber, a marine invertebrate, remains hidden in a crack. The tentacled flathead also resides permanently on the seabed. Meanwhile, the masked puffer has calmed down once again and reverted to its normal shape. An emperor angelfish. Each of these magnificent fish claims a large territory of the reef and is quite prepared to defend it against other members of its own species. The grey-seine turtle has had enough of the reef and sets off into open water. It is also time for us to leave behind the amazing variety of life in the coral ocean. Our diving expedition has revealed to us one of the richest ecosystems on this planet. We have been able to feast our eyes on an incredible wealth of life in all its shapes and colors, as varied as anything to be found anywhere in the world. The coral reefs in the Red Sea are among the most fascinating underwater worlds on our planet. These reefs, which are only found in the shallow zones of warm tropical oceans where the sunlight filters through the water, are enormously complex and extensive ecosystems in their own right. They are sometimes known as rainforests of the ocean, because the wealth of species found here can only really be compared with that in tropical rainforests. We prepare for a dive that will present us with a veritable fairy tale world featuring a breathtaking diversity of life forms. Almost as soon as we are in the water, we are greeted by a shoal of sea goldies. These striking orange-yellow fish can form shoals of up to 2,000 individuals. They eat plankton and like to gather at the edge of the reef where the current will drive their preferred prey towards them. A pair of blue tangs appear right in front of us and quickly flee. The coral hind gives us considerably more time to admire it. Coral hinds are among the largest fish on the reef, and as predators, they are high up in the food chain. The Red Sea bannerfish is a far gentler creature. It is one of the family of butterfly fish, which includes some of the most beautiful fish species in the coral oceans.
In contrast, the common lionfish is far from being harmless. Its long spines contain a powerful poison.
The vivid yellow-blue-cheeked butterfly fish is a close relative of the Red Sea bannerfish we have just encountered. The sea anemone is a class of creature known as anthozoans, or flower animals. Although the orbicular batfish looks similar to the butterfly fish, it is not, in fact, a relative. Its preferred habitat is deep water, and in the Red Sea, these fish can be extremely trusting. The partnership between the sea anemone and the anemone fish is one of the best examples of a symbiotic relationship between completely different creatures or species of plants in which both parties benefit from the symbiosis. Striated fusiliers always remain in large shoals in the free water above the reef, where they can hunt for animal plankton. Giant mound corals are a kind of stony coral, which form calcium exoskeletons. They can become extremely large and sometimes form dome-like blocks on the reef. The long tentacles of the anemone are equipped with stinging cells, used to immobilize small fish, which can then be digested. Only the anemone fish can move between the tentacles without being harmed. Thus, the anemone fish is protected from larger predators here, while at the same time it performs a valuable service to the anemone by defending it against predators. This impressive fellow belongs to the family of wrasses and is known as a humphead wrasse. It is one of the largest fish on the reef and can grow to an amazing size. The biggest specimen ever caught was 7.5 feet in length and weighed 470 pounds. A green sea turtle appears on the reef. This species was hunted to the very brink of extinction because its meat was highly prized as the main ingredient of green turtle soup. We once again meet the Red Sea bannerfish, as usual, patrolling their territory in pairs. While swimming, the turtle only uses its front fins for propulsion. The rear ones are used purely for steering. Two surgeonfish take the opportunity to pick away at parasites. A small group of cardinal fish are lying in wait under a protective outcrop, while the large humphead wrasse goes on its rounds. It has powerful jaws, which can easily bite through the shell of crustaceans. However, it represents no danger to these little shoaling fish. Another turtle appears near the surface. It is not alone. Two suckerfish are stubbornly attempting to attach themselves to its shell. These fish have dorsal fins, which are modified to form suction pads, and this allows them to fasten on to larger creatures or boats and hitch a lift in this way. A barnacle has already had some success here. This crustacean, which looks like a small volcanic cone, has established a permanent home for itself on the turtle's shell. The turtle itself doesn't seem to mind, being predominantly interested in the seagrass bed on the bottom of the ocean. Like all sea turtles, the green turtle lays its eggs on the beach and leaves them to hatch in the sun. The female always chooses the same beach where she herself hatched out many years earlier. And exactly how she manages to find this spot again remains a mystery to scientists.
A large shoal of mackerel comes past, looking like a spherical cloud. These fish always live in shoals, with each individual reacting to the movements of all the others. This huge group, which results, occasionally appears to move like a conscious organism. This giant moray has a completely different lifestyle. Like all members of its family, it hunts alone and, as a rule, is active at night. The monochrome red saber squirrelfish is also a night hunter. During the day, it remains hidden in caves or crevices in the coral reef. Shipwrecks can become an important part of the ecosystem in coral oceans because they offer retreats and hiding places to a wide variety of fish species and other marine creatures. Moreover, they quickly become covered in coral and can consequently form the nucleus of completely new reefs. Here, a colorful and very mixed group has gathered among the rusting steel parts of the vessel. The wreck looks as though it has been planted with a wide variety of coral. The Red Sea bannerfish also feels at home on this artificial reef. It always remains close to reefs and never swims out into the open water. The bizarre cornetfish is quite unmistakable with its needle-like body and disproportionately elongated mouth. Sea urchins hide among the coral. They belong to the class of creatures known as invertebrates, and they protect themselves with a hard external skeleton covered in poisonous spines. This magnificent creature is a Spanish dancer, a kind of sea slug. The red-pink segments are its gills. The masked puffer can easily be recognized by its facial coloring, which looks like a mask. Like all pufferfish, it is highly poisonous. A large shoal of striated fusiliers is swarming above us. They are not regular inhabitants of reefs, preferring to remain.
The coral reefs in the Red Sea are among the most fascinating underwater worlds on our planet. These reefs, which are only found in the shallow zones of warm tropical oceans where the sunlight filters through the water, are enormously complex and extensive ecosystems in their own right. They are sometimes known as rainforests of the ocean, because the wealth of species found here can only really be compared with that in tropical rainforests. We prepare for a dive that will present us with a veritable fairy tale world featuring a breathtaking diversity of life forms. Almost as soon as we are in the water, we are greeted by a shoal of sea goldies. These striking orange-yellow fish can form shoals of up to 2,000 individuals. They eat plankton and like to gather at the edge of the reef where the current will drive their preferred prey towards them. A pair of blue tangs appear right in front of us and quickly flee. The coral hind gives us considerably more time to admire it.
Coral hinds are among the largest fish on the reef, and as predators, they are high up in the food chain. The Red Sea bannerfish is a far gentler creature. It is one of the family of butterfly fish, which includes some of the most beautiful fish species in the coral oceans. In contrast, the common lionfish is far from being harmless. Its long spines contain a powerful poison.
The vivid yellow-blue-cheeked butterfly fish is a close relative of the Red Sea bannerfish we have just encountered. The sea anemone is a class of creature known as
anthozoans, or flower animals. Although the orbicular batfish looks similar to the butterfly fish, it is not, in fact, a relative. Its preferred habitat is deep water, and in the Red Sea, these fish can be extremely trusting. The partnership between the sea anemone and the anemone fish is one of the best examples of a symbiotic relationship between completely different creatures or species of plants in which both parties benefit from the symbiosis. Striated fusiliers always remain in large shoals in the free water above the reef, where they can hunt for animal plankton. Giant mound corals are a kind of stony coral, which form calcium exoskeletons. They can become extremely large and sometimes form dome-like blocks on the reef. The long tentacles of the anemone are equipped with stinging cells, used to immobilize small fish, which can then be digested. Only the anemone fish can move between the tentacles without being harmed. Thus, the anemone fish is protected from larger predators here, while at the same time it performs a valuable service to the anemone by defending it against predators. This impressive fellow belongs to the family of wrasses and is known as a humphead wrasse. It is one of the largest fish on the reef and can grow to an amazing size. The biggest specimen ever caught was 7.5 feet in length and weighed 470 pounds. A green sea turtle appears on the reef. This species was hunted to the very brink of extinction because its meat was highly prized as the main ingredient of green turtle soup. We once again meet the Red Sea bannerfish, as usual, patrolling their territory in pairs. While swimming, the turtle only uses its front fins for propulsion. The rear ones are used purely for steering. Two surgeonfish take the opportunity to pick away at parasites. A small group of cardinal fish are lying in wait under a protective outcrop, while the large humphead wrasse goes on its rounds. It has powerful jaws, which can easily bite through the shell of crustaceans. However, it represents no danger to these little shoaling fish. Another turtle appears near the surface. It is not alone. Two suckerfish are stubbornly attempting to attach themselves to its shell. These fish have dorsal fins, which are modified to form suction pads, and this allows them to fasten on to larger creatures or boats and hitch a lift in this way. A barnacle has already had some success here. This crustacean, which looks like a small volcanic cone, has established a permanent home for itself on the turtle's shell. The turtle itself doesn't seem to mind. being predominantly interested in the seagrass bed on the bottom of the ocean. Like all sea turtles, the green turtle lays its eggs on the beach and leaves them to hatch in the sun. The female always chooses the same beach where she herself hatched out many years earlier. And exactly how she manages to find this spot again remains a mystery to scientists. A large shoal of mackerel comes past, looking like a spherical cloud. These fish always live in shoals, with each individual reacting to the movements of all the others. This huge group which results occasionally appears to move like a conscious organism. This giant moray has a completely different lifestyle. Like all members of its family, it hunts alone and as a rule is active at night. The monochrome red saber squirrelfish is also a night hunter. During the day, it remains hidden in caves or crevices in the coral reef. Shipwrecks can become an important part of the ecosystem in coral oceans because they offer retreats and hiding places to a wide variety of fish species and other marine creatures. Moreover, they quickly become covered in coral and can consequently form the nucleus of completely new reefs. Here, a colorful and very mixed group has gathered among the rusting steel parts of the vessel. The wreck looks as though it has been planted with a wide variety of coral. The Red Sea Bannerfish also feels at home on this artificial reef. It always remains close to reefs and never swims out into the open water. The bizarre cornetfish is quite unmistakable with its needle-like body and disproportionately elongated mouth. Sea urchins hide among the coral. They belong to the class of creatures known as invertebrates, and they protect themselves with a hard external skeleton covered in poisonous spines. This magnificent creature is a Spanish dancer, a kind of sea slug. The red-pink segments are its gills. The masked puffer can easily be recognized by its facial coloring, which looks like a mask. Like all pufferfish, it is highly poisonous. A large shoal of striated fusiliers is swarming above us. They are not regular inhabitants of reefs, preferring to remain in open water. Sea fans are among the most spectacular manifestations of coral life. They form large, fan-like structures with delicate branches that can reach a diameter of up to 6.5 feet. These corals live from tiny plankton which they filter out of the current. Consequently, fans are always arranged across the direction the current takes. These large, tree-like structures provide protection for a number of small life forms such as crabs, shrimp, and starfish. Here, a Bali fire anemone has taken up residence between the branches of the sea fan. Although this species of anemone seems similar to the coral itself at first glance, the two are very distant relatives. Unlike the stony coral that forms the reef, this tree coral does not have a hard exoskeleton. Instead, it retains its shape by means of increased water pressure acting on their inner surfaces. A shoal of black-spotted rubber lips floats above the reef. These fish are predominantly nocturnal, and during the day they stay close to the reef in shoals. Stony corals are the real master builders of the reef. They are colonies of tiny creatures which construct calcium exoskeletons. When the coral polyp dies, the skeleton remains, and over the years, generations of coral polyps construct their own exoskeletons on top of earlier colonies. This is how huge reefs are created, forming the foundation of life for the entire ecosystem. We have encountered this masked puffer before. Like all pufferfish, it leads a solitary existence. By contrast, the yellowfin goldfish are genuine shoaling fish. During the day, they remain on the edge of the reef in huge, magnificent shoals. They do not really become active until nightfall, when they fan out to hunt tiny invertebrates that live on the seabed. In the process, they sometimes dig up the sandy floor so thoroughly that large clouds of sand are created. Blue-cheeked butterfly fish, with their flat bodies, have adopted an outstanding fashion to life on the reef, and they always remain close to the coral branches. They feed on the coral polyps, and each one has a small hunting ground which it defends against other members of its own species. Even more striking than the butterfly fish is the angelfish, which are among the most richly colored sea creatures of all. A zebra lionfish wends its solitary way through a shoal of sea goldies, which make sure they keep a respectful distance from its poisonous spines. These moon-tailed bullseyes are far more sociable creatures. Their huge eyes have adapted to their nocturnal life. The lionfish is also predominantly active at night. During the day, it hides in crevices or caves and is seldom glimpsed in open water. It waits patiently for its prey to make an appearance. Then it sucks the hapless creature into its huge mouth by suddenly lowering the pressure inside. However, the bullseyes have nothing to fear. They are too big for the lionfish to consider one a possible victim. The skittish shoal of green chromies scurries around among the stony coral, watched with interest by a black-tip grouper. The chocolate-dip chromies, with its striking black and white coloring, belongs to the extremely extensive family of pomacentrids. As is the case with bullseyes, they also live in loose shoals. Mollus corals, seen here with pufferfish above them, are a species of stony coral. The undulating shape is reminiscent of some kinds of the blue-spotted ribbon-tail ray often buries itself in the sand as a form of camouflage. This is also where it finds food in the form of worms, shrimp, and shellfish, which it digs up from the sand. Unlike the larger manta ray, the ribbon tail always remains on the seabed and is never seen in open water. The stings at the base of its tail contain a powerful poison that could be deadly even for human beings. This ray is not aggressive, but if you were to step on it by mistake, the consequences could be pretty serious. The black surgeonfish is dark brown in color with only a white ring around its tail to form a contrast. Surgeonfish take their name from two spines, one on each side of the tail, which are as sharp as scalpels and can be extended when the fish is provoked. Yellow-edged leer tails are a subspecies of sea bass. Lunar fusiliers are typical shoaling fish. If they are attacked, they attempt to confuse the predator with synchronized swimming movements. As it swims past, the leer tail once again displays to us its splendid coloring. As plankton eaters, fusiliers are quite capable of friendly cohabitation with different fish species and often mix with shoals of other types. Here they have combined with some striking yellow gold saddle goatfish and silver big-eyed trevallies to form a multicolored The magnificent Red Sea bannerfish also enjoys a diet of plankton, but they tend to remain in more sheltered areas and do not form shoals. Table corals produce a hard exoskeleton and are therefore considered a species of stony coral. They create tree-like shapes with numerous branches. In the deeper water at the side of the reef, they grow into structures resembling tables, since this permits them to absorb as much light as possible. Stony corals live in a symbiotic relationship with single-cell algae, which require sunlight for their photosynthesis. Consequently, like plants, these corals require locations which are rich in natural light. A shoal of sea goldies dodges around the multi-layered coral forest. Corals can appear in a wide variety of forms. Thus, solid stony corals form the foundation of the reef, which is then settled by lace-like species such as sea fans and table corals. Tree corals also have no hard skeleton and move gently in the current. A moray eel is lurking among the corals, on the lookout for a victim, its long body hidden in the hollow space. During the night, the reef takes on a completely different appearance. When an ultraviolet spotlight is trained upon it, this mushroom coral glows with a pale fluorescent light. A hammerhead shark approaches from the distance. Its distinctive shape makes this species of shark, which can be up to 13 feet in length, one of the most striking inhabitants of the coral ocean. However, it is only an occasional visitor to the reef, since its sphere of activity extends more. This curious creature is a Pleurobranchus grandis, a species of side gill slug. Numerous species of sea slugs can be found in the Red Sea, some of them with extremely beautiful coloring. A black and white snapper continues on its solitary path in the middle of a shoal of chocolate dip chromies. This fish, which can grow to a considerable size, prefers open water, which it finds in deeper lagoons or on the steep edges of reefs. Once again, we encounter a green sea turtle, resting on the seabed before setting off again in search of food. With its distinctive needle-shaped body. This stunning creature is known as an elegant unicorn fish. Like the majority of unicorn fish, it is extremely striking with its brightly colored appearance. Unlike unicorn fish, which tend to be solitary hunters, yellowfin goldfish like to spend the daylight hours in large shoals. Not until night comes do they split up, setting off individually in search. The Spanish dancer we saw earlier in a relaxed position has now become active, revealing itself in all its splendor. This large sea slug swims through open water with an undulating motion, and it now becomes apparent where its name originates. The resemblance to a flamenco dancer in traditional dress is quite striking. Apparently, we have disturbed this masked puffer somewhat. When it senses danger, it fills itself with water, making it look larger than it actually is. Now that dusk is approaching, these bullseyes are becoming active. Their shoals frequently contain other shoaling fish, such as these black striped sweepers, which flash silver in the spotlight. They hunt for animal plankton at night, always remaining in the safety of the shoal. Occasionally, very mixed shoals congregate at places which offer protection, such as under this roof. Many species of fish avoid open water whenever possible and tend to remain in sheltered spots like this. This surgeonfish seems to have rather a nervous disposition, hurrying away when we dive slowly between the protruding coral. Toothed cardinal fish, which has distinctive colored stripes on its body. Tail butterfly fish make an appearance. They live in couples and generally patrol their small territories, which they will defend against other members of their own species with their partners. A shoal of striated fusiliers swirls around over the reef in search of food. These fish feed on animal plankton and are frequently found in the open water areas near the reef. Cornet fish seems rather exotic with its highly individual shape. A large shoal of sea goldies dodges around the reef like an orange cloud. Naturally, all this activity attracts predators, such as this barracuda and a snapper.
These creatures are extremely sociable and always live in small groups known as schools. Coral reefs in the Red Sea are among the most fascinating underwater worlds on our planet. These reefs, which are only found in the shallow zones of warm tropical oceans where the sunlight filters through the water, are enormously complex and extensive ecosystems in their own right. They are sometimes known as rainforests of the ocean, because the wealth of species found here can only really be compared with that in tropical rainforests. We prepare for a dive that will present us with a veritable fairy tale world featuring a breathtaking diversity of life forms. Almost as soon as we are in the water, we are greeted by a shoal of sea goldies. These striking orange-yellow fish can form shoals of up to 2,000 individuals. They eat plankton and like to gather at the edge of the reef where the current will drive their preferred prey towards them. A pair of blue tangs appear right in front of us and quickly flee. The coral hind gives us considerably more time to admire it. Coral hinds are among the largest fish on the reef, and as predators, they are high up in the food chain. The Red Sea bannerfish is a far gentler creature. It is one of the family of butterfly fish, which includes some of the most beautiful fish species in the coral oceans. In contrast, the common lionfish is far from being harmless. Its long spines contain a powerful poison. The vivid yellow-blue-cheeked butterfly fish is a close relative of the Red Sea bannerfish we have just encountered. The sea anemone is a class of creature known as anthozoans, or flower animals. Although the orbicular batfish looks similar to the butterfly fish, it is not, in fact, a relative. Its preferred habitat is deep water, and in the Red Sea, these fish can be extremely trusting. The partnership between the sea anemone and the anemone fish is one of the best examples of a symbiotic relationship between completely different creatures or species of plants, in which both parties benefit from the symbiosis. Striated fusiliers always remain in large shoals in the free water above the reef, where they can hunt for animal plankton. Giant mound corals are a kind of stony coral, which form calcium exoskeletons. They can become extremely large and sometimes form dome-like blocks on the reef. The long tentacles of the anemone are equipped with stinging cells, used to immobilize small fish, which can then be digested. Only the anemone fish can move between the tentacles without being harmed. Thus, the anemone fish is protected from larger predators here, while at the same time it performs a valuable service to the anemone by defending it against predators. This impressive fellow belongs to the family of wrasses and is known as a humphead wrasse. It is one of the largest fish on the reef and can grow to an amazing size. The biggest specimen ever caught was 7.5 feet in length and weighed
470 pounds. A green sea turtle appears on the reef. This species was hunted to the very brink of extinction because its meat was highly prized as the main ingredient of green turtle soup. We once again meet the red sea bannerfish, as usual, patrolling their territory in pairs. While swimming, the turtle only uses its front fins for propulsion. The rear ones are used purely for steering. Two surgeon fish take the opportunity to pick away at parasites. A small group of cardinal fish are lying in wait under a protective outcrop, while the large humphead wrasse goes on its rounds. It has powerful jaws, which can easily bite through the shell of crustaceans. However, it represents no danger to these little shoaling fish. Another turtle appears near the surface. It is not alone. Two suckerfish are stubbornly attempting to attach themselves to its shell. These fish have dorsal fins, which are modified to form suction pads, and this allows them to fasten on to larger creatures or boats and hitch a lift in this way. A barnacle has already had some success here. This crustacean, which looks like a small volcanic cone, has established a permanent home for itself on the turtle's shell. The turtle itself doesn't seem to mind, being predominantly interested in the seagrass bed on the bottom of the ocean. Like all sea turtles, the green turtle lays its eggs on the beach and leaves them to hatch in the sun. The female always chooses the same beach where she herself hatched out many years earlier. And exactly how she manages to find this spot again remains a mystery to scientists. A large shoal of mackerel comes past, looking like a spherical cloud. These fish always live in shoals, with each individual reacting to the movements of all the others. This huge group, which results, occasionally appears to move like a conscious organism. This giant moray has a completely different lifestyle. Like all members of its family, it hunts alone and, as a rule, is active at night. The monochrome red saber squirrelfish is also a night hunter. During the day, it remains hidden in caves or crevices in the coral reef. Shipwrecks can become an important part of the ecosystem in coral oceans because they offer retreats and hiding places to a wide variety of fish species and other marine creatures. Moreover, they quickly become covered in coral and can consequently form the nucleus of completely new reefs. Here, a colorful and very mixed group has gathered among the rusting steel parts of the vessel. The wreck looks as though it has been planted with a wide variety of coral. The red sea bannerfish also feels at home on this artificial reef. It always remains close to reefs and never swims out into the open water. The bizarre cornet fish is quite unmistakable with its needle-like body and disproportionately elongated mouth. Sea urchins hide among the coral. They belong to the class of creatures known as invertebrates, and they protect themselves with a hard external skeleton covered in poisonous spines. This magnificent creature is a Spanish dancer, a kind of sea slug. The red-pink segments are its gills. The masked puffer can easily be recognized by its facial coloring, which looks like a mask. Like all pufferfish, it is highly poisonous. A large shoal of striated fusiliers is swarming above us. They are not regular inhabitants of reefs, preferring to remain in open water. Sea fans are among the most spectacular manifestations of coral life. They form large, fan-like structures with delicate branches that can reach a diameter of up to 6.5 feet. These corals live from tiny plankton which they filter out of the current. Consequently, fans are always arranged across the direction the current takes. These large, tree-like structures provide protection for a number of small life forms such as crabs, shrimp, and starfish. Here, a Bali fire anemone has taken up residence between the branches of the sea fan. Although this species of anemone seems similar to the coral itself at first glance, the two are very distant relatives. Unlike the stony coral that forms the reef, this tree coral does not have a hard exoskeleton. Instead, it retains its shape by means of increased water pressure acting on their inner surfaces. A shoal of black-spotted rubberlips floats above the reef. These fish are predominantly nocturnal, and during the day they stay close to the reef in shoals. Stony corals are the real master builders of the reef. They are colonies of tiny creatures which construct calcium exoskeletons. When the coral polyp dies, the skeleton remains, and over the years, generations of coral polyps construct their own exoskeletons on top of earlier colonies. This is how huge reefs are created, forming the foundation of life for the entire ecosystem. We have encountered this masked puffer before. Like all pufferfish, it leads a solitary existence. By contrast, the yellowfin goldfish are genuine shoaling fish. During the day, they remain on the edge of the reef in huge, magnificent shoals. They do not really become active until nightfall, when they fan out to hunt tiny invertebrates that live on the seabed. In the process, they sometimes dig up the sandy floor so thoroughly that large clouds of sand are created. Blue-cheeked butterfly fish, with their flat bodies, have adopted an outstanding fashion to life on the reef, and they always remain close to the coral branches. They feed on the coral polyps, and each one has a small hunting ground which it defends against other members of its own species. Even more striking than the butterfly fish is the angelfish, which are among the most richly colored sea creatures of all. A zebra lionfish wends its solitary way through a shoal of sea goldies, which make sure they keep a respectful distance from its poisonous spines.
These moon-tailed bullseyes are far more sociable creatures. Their huge eyes have adapted to their nocturnal life. The lionfish is also predominantly active at night. During the day, it hides in crevices or caves and is seldom glimpsed in open water. It waits patiently for its prey to make an appearance. Then it sucks the hapless creature into its huge mouth by suddenly lowering the pressure inside. However, the bullseyes have nothing to fear.
They are too big for the lionfish to consider one a possible victim. The skittish shoal of green chromies scurries around among the stony coral,
watched with interest by a black-tip grouper. The chocolate-dip chromies, with its striking black and white coloring, belongs to the extremely extensive family of pomacentrids. As is the case with bullseyes, they also live in loose shoals. Mollus corals, seen here with pufferfish above them, are a species of stony coral. The undulating shape is reminiscent of some kinds of the blue-spotted ribbon-tail ray often buries itself in the sand as a form of camouflage. This is also where it finds food in the form of worms, shrimp, and shellfish, which it digs up from the sand. Unlike the larger manta ray, the ribbon-tail always remains on the seabed and is never seen in open water. The stings at the base of its tail contain a powerful poison that could be deadly even for human beings. This ray is not aggressive, but if you were to step on it by mistake, the consequences could be pretty serious. The black surgeonfish is dark brown in color with only a white ring around its tail to form a contrast. Surgeonfish take their name from two spines, one on each side of the tail,
which are as sharp as scalpels and can be extended when the fish is provoked. Yellow-edged leer tails are a subspecies of sea bass. Lunar fusiliers are typical shoaling fish. If they are attacked, they attempt to confuse the predator with synchronized swimming movements. As it swims past, the leer tail once again displays to us its splendid coloring. As plankton eaters, fusiliers are quite capable of friendly cohabitation with different fish species and often mix with shoals of other types. Here they have combined with some striking yellow gold-saddled goatfish and silver big-eyed trevallies to form a multicolored
The magnificent red sea bannerfish also enjoys a diet of plankton,
but they tend to remain in more sheltered areas and do not form shoals. Table corals produce a hard exoskeleton and are therefore considered a species of stony coral. They create tree-like shapes with numerous branches. In the deeper water at the side of the reef, they grow into structures resembling tables, since this permits them to absorb
as much light as possible. Stony corals live in a symbiotic relationship with single-cell algae, which require sunlight for their photosynthesis. Consequently, like plants, these corals require locations which are rich in natural light. A shoal of sea goldies dodges around the multi-layered coral forest. Corals can appear in a wide variety of forms. Thus, solid stony corals form the foundation of the reef, which is then settled by lace-like
species such as sea fans and table corals. Tree corals also have no hard skeleton and move gently in the current.
A moray eel is lurking among the corals, on the lookout for a victim, its long body hidden in the hollow space. During the night, the reef takes on a completely different appearance. When an ultraviolet spotlight is trained upon it, this mushroom coral glows with a pale fluorescent light. A hammerhead shark approaches from the distance. Its distinctive shape makes this species of shark, which can be up to 13 feet in length, one of the most striking inhabitants of the coral ocean.
However, it is only an occasional visitor to the reef, since its sphere of activity extends This curious creature is a Pleurobranchus grandis, a species of side gill slug. Numerous species of sea slugs can be found in the Red Sea, some of them with extremely beautiful coloring.
A black and white snapper continues on its solitary path in the middle of a shoal of chocolate-dip chromies. This fish, which can grow to a considerable size, prefers open water, which it finds in deeper lagoons or on the steep edges of reefs. Once again, we encounter a green sea turtle, resting on the seabed before setting off again in search of food. with its distinctive needle-shaped body. This stunning creature is known as an elegant unicorn fish. Like the majority of unicorn fish, it is extremely striking with its brightly colored appearance. Unlike unicorn fish, which tend to be solitary hunters, yellowfin goldfish like to spend the daylight hours in large shoals. Not until night comes do they split up, setting off individually in search. The Spanish dancer we saw earlier in a relaxed position has now become active, revealing itself in all its splendor. This large sea slug swims through open water with an undulating motion, and it now becomes apparent where its name originates. The resemblance to a flamenco dancer in traditional dress is quite striking. Currently, we have disturbed this masked puffer somewhat. When it senses danger, it fills itself with water, making it look larger than it actually is. Now that dusk is approaching, these bullseyes are becoming active. Their shoals frequently contain other shoaling fish, such as these black striped sweepers, which flash silver in the spotlight. They hunt for animal plankton at night, always remaining in the safety of the shoal. Occasionally, very mixed shoals congregate at places which offer protection, such as under this roof. Many species of fish avoid open water whenever possible and tend to remain in sheltered spots like this. This surgeonfish seems to have rather a nervous disposition, hurrying away when we dive slowly between the protruding coral. Toothed cardinal fish, which has distinctive colored stripes on its body.
tailed butterfly fish make an appearance. They live in couples and generally patrol their small territories, which they will defend against other members of their own species with their partners. A shoal of striated fusiliers swirls around over the reef in search of food. These fish feed on animal plankton and are frequently found in the open water areas near the reef.
Hornet fish seems rather exotic with its highly individual shape. A large shoal of sea goldies dodges around the reef like an orange cloud.
Naturally, all this activity attracts predators, such as this barracuda and a snapper. These creatures are extremely sociable and always live in small groups known as schools. The gray spots on the belly of the dolphins indicate that these particular creatures are Indo-Pacific bottlenose dolphins. However, the patchwork of gray spots only appears on older animals. With a length of up to 8.5 feet, they are one of the smaller species of dolphin. They can frequently be found in tropical and subtropical oceans, and they tend to remain close to the coast in schools of between 5 and 15 animals.
Dolphins are curious, playful animals. Although this can hardly be the first time they have seen divers, they are determined to take a closer look at us. This results in a fascinating encounter with these absolutely extraordinary creatures.
A shoal of yellowfin goldfish has pressed itself close to the reef for safety. Only gradually do they venture out again.
The butterfly fish also prefers to wait in the safety of a cave until the coast is clear once. These red sea anemone fish prefer in any case not to stray far away from the anemones which provide them with protection. The stinging tentacles of the anemone are deadly to other fish, but the anemone fish enjoys immunity due to a special layer of mucus on their skin, and thus they are able to remain inside the anemone. Consequently, they are forced to seek safety in numbers by forming shoals. A shoal of chocolate-dipped chromies plays over a large field of porites coral. This type of coral has characteristic finger-like pillars and forms large patches. This makes little impression on the turtle, however. It has found something else to eat. The coral hind is also too big to pay much attention to such things. This blue-spotted ribbon-tail ray keeps a low profile, as always, waiting half buried in the sand for its prey. A five-saddled parrotfish has withdrawn to a small cave for a sleep. Like all parrotfish, it has powerful jaws and can therefore graze on the algae layers on the stony coral. The giant moray would not be content with such meager fare. It lurks in wait for small